Hello and welcome to my channel, The Computer Lab. In this video, I'm going to show you how to move a static image using keyframes in iMovie. So if you're wanting to learn how to create a video similar to the one in the middle with a static image with movement applied using keyframes, please carry on watching. Hello and welcome to The Computer Lab. So today's video, we are going to be looking at keyframing in iMovie on your Mac. Okay, so I'm going to start off. I've obviously got iMovie already open, and I am going to select a video clip. This is just a clip that I downloaded from the internet, one that's free to use, and it's just a bar. I've used this in a previous video. So it's basically showing people sat at a bar with a stationary camera. So I'm going to drag that into my timeline. Obviously, you'll have something different. And also I'm going to use this football here. This again is a PNG that I created on the Mac. So if you want to see how to create a PNG on a Mac, just go to one of my previous videos, how to create a PNG on the Mac for free. Okay, so let's get this PNG dragged onto the timeline. So the PNG that I've just dragged in, I'm going to drag that the full length so it matches the clip underneath. And what iMovie does, it applies a standard template when you drag sort of a PNG or this type of file in that gives you this zoom effect, which we will remove in a second. So go to the cropping tool at the top, click on the cropping tool, we don't want it cropped, and we also want to click on fit, so it fits within a designated box. And we also need to click on the video overlay settings tab, click on that one. We don't want to cut away, click on there and go picture in picture. So basically that overlays our picture on top of the video, and the crop tool tells it that we want to fit within this box. So we can resize this if we want. I'm going to have it probably about that big. And then we need to go to the start of the video. So I'm just going to drag, let me just highlight the clip that I want, the image I want, and I'm going to drag the football to say, let's say here, I'm going to put it about that. Okay, and then we'll get to the beginning of the video. And also, you'll notice these little tabs on the top of the video timeline here. These are the fading tabs. So if I'm going to the ball now, you see as I start from the video and as I come across, it starts to fade in. And if I drag that little blue dot across, that then fades it in very slow. I don't want any fading, so I'm just going to drag it right to the end. And both ends will do the same. Okay, so we've got that now. So now we need to start adding the keyframes. So wherever you're wanting to start the movement on your image, you need to select that point on your timeline. I'm going to start roughly about the beginning. So I'm going to start about here, just as it starts, and then start to move. So this is the first point of the keyframe. So again, we need to go up to the top menu again. We need to click on the video overlay settings. And then we need to make sure that this keyframe box is ready for us to go. So as I hover over the top of the keyframe, it will give us the option to add a new keyframe. If I'd already started the process, I get the option to delete the keyframe. And the way that keyframing works in iMovie, it does it all automatically once you start the process. So the idea is to start the keyframe where you wanted to start the movement. So I'm going to start mine here. So I'm going to click on that. So now I've started the process. I need to play the video to the point where I want it, my next movement to stop or start. So the way to get a nice smooth action and keyframing is to look at your timeline, time counter, and look at the seconds that's ticking by, and that will give you the smooth point as you go along. So I'll explain that as I do that now. So as I zoom in on the timeline, I'll show you here, I'm going to push the space bar to push play, and I've already told it that I'm doing the keyframe at this point, so I've not clicked anything else. I'm going to push the space bar to play. I'm going to do about 3 seconds, I think. So I'm going to stop now. I'm at the 3 second point. And now I need to drag my ball to where it's going to go to next. So I'm going to drag that straight up and then let go. So that now, I don't need to click anything else. iMovie now knows that within them 3 seconds, it wants to go from that position up to the top position. Okay, so now I'm going to go another 3 seconds. Stop there. And I'm going to drag the ball back down. So now it's going to go to about there. So I'm going to do this a couple of times. So I'm going to get another 3 seconds. And I'm basically just going to do that a couple more times. So when you left click on your mouse and drag, and as soon as you let go, that tells iMovie that's where the keyframe is. And drag again. And the only reason I'm doing 3 seconds is just so the movement's smooth. If I did let the video play longer, the movement would be slower because it would be going from one point to the other within the time that you decide to move your keyframe. So now I've done that movement, the ball will go up, down, up, down. I'll play it. We'll go to the beginning, then we'll start a new keyframe to finish the process off. So I'm going to go to the beginning of the video, push play. So you see that's the first 3 seconds, 1, 2, 3, then another 3 seconds. It's going to hit the bar, then back up again, another 3 seconds, and then back down to its sort of end point. Okay, so I'm happy with that. And now I'm going to add another keyframe. And you can also take the off screen. So what I'm going to do is possibly bounce the ball up here, bounce it off the top, and then shoot it off the screen. And I might do that within 2 seconds, so the ball goes quicker. So again, I'm watching the counter here, and I'm going to start my keyframe off. So back again, up to the video overlay settings tab. Click on that one. Wait for your keyframe to be shown. So I can add me starting my keyframe at this point. I need to just make sure that I'm working within this layer. So I'm going to now add my keyframe. So that's the first keyframe. So like I said, I'm going to do this every 2 seconds, I think. So I'm starting at 13. So my next stop is 15. So I've not moved anything yet. Push play. So that's my end point. So I'm going to go to the side of the screen there. Another 2 seconds. Then go to the top. And then I'm going to do another 2 seconds. Stop there. And then finally another 2 seconds. So and then drag it off the screen for that one. And we finish in there. Okay, so I'm happy with that. So let's get to the beginning of the video. Let's see what our video looks like. So again, these are the 3 second points. So 3 seconds to the top, 3 seconds back down again, 3 seconds back up, 3 seconds back down. So now we should shoot across to the left, hit the side of the left, up to the top, hit the top, and then bounce back down all the way off the screen. Okay, so that's it. That's how to use keyframe in iMovie on your Mac and how to create movement with PNGs on your Mac. I also have done another video which shows you how to create automatic movements and how to import them into iMovie, and that's done within Keynote. That's one, how to green screen in iMovie, again on my channel. But if the video has helped, please do hit the subscribe button. Please also hit the bell icon to be alerted to any new videos. And if there's a how-to video you'd like me to look at, please do leave me any suggestions in the comments box below.